गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन. नाउ अगेन आई एम टेकिंग अप योर चैप्टर फैक्टराइजेशन. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डू एक्सरसाइज 14F. नाउ विच इज अगेन बेस्ड ऑन द फॉर्मूला ए स्क्वायर माइनस बी स्क्वायर. एंड द फैक्टर्स ऑफ ए स्क्वायर माइनस बी स्क्वायर आर ए प्लस बी ए माइनस बी. इन दिस एक्सरसाइज द क्वेश्चंस आर डिफरेंट फ्रॉम वॉट यू हैव डन इट इन योर Exercise 14E. A little different, but the formula to be used will be the same. Now the question says factorize. Now I am taking up the second question. The second question is 3x minus 2y whole square minus 9z whole square. Now you are going to write it as 3x minus 2y whole square. And 9z square is the square of 3z. It is 3z whole square. Now I think you know now how to make the factors. This complete binomial is the value of A. And this is the value of B. So the factors are A plus B, A minus B. So you will take it as 3x minus 2y plus 3z as one factor. And 3x minus 2y minus 3z as the other factor. So this I have factorized for you the question given. Now I am taking up the fifth question. Fifth question is 16 with x plus y whole square minus 25 and the binomial x minus y whole square. Now you know 16 is the square of 4. So square of x plus y and of 4, we will take it common. And you are going to get the question as this. 4 x plus y, remain it within the brackets, put it in within brackets only, and take the square common. So 16 I have written as 4 square. This square is for 4 as well as for x plus y. Minus 25 is the square of 5. And this square of x minus y, both the squares will again be taken common outside the bracket. Now in the next step, do the multiplication of 4 with this binomial, or in other words, open up the bracket and you will get 4x plus 4y square remains there only, square minus 5x minus 5y. This 5x minus 5y to be put within the brackets only, whole square. So this is equal to, now this complete becomes A and this complete binomial becomes B. So now it is again changed into the form of A square minus B square. So what are the factors? A plus B, A minus B. So once we are going to add them, plus 5x minus 5y, and other time we are going to subtract them. This is one factor when you put plus, and the second time you are going to subtract them. 4x plus 4y minus, in the next line I am writing minus 5x minus 5y is, so this is A plus B and this is A minus B. Now I am removing this question which I had written before only. Now I am continuing this question. Now open up the bracket. What will you get? 4x plus 4y plus 5x. Minus 4y. And when you open up the bracket for the second, you will get it as 4x plus 4y as there is minus outside the bracket, and when you open it, you will get minus 5x plus 5y. Now in the next step, you can add up the like terms. 4x plus 5x will become 9x. 4y minus, now this was 5y. 4y minus 5y will become minus y. It was 5x minus 5y. This is one factor. We are taking up the like terms together. And it is 4x plus 4y minus 5x plus 5y. 4x minus 5x are the like terms. Subtract them, you will get minus x. And 4y added to 5y will give you plus 9y. So these are the two factors of your this question. Now I am taking up the 8th question. 8th question is 3 minus 12 b square. Now in order to factorize this, I told you when you go to the next step, you should put equal to. In order to factorize this, you see 3 is not the square of any number, even 12 is not the square of any number. So first we are going to take out the common term outside, which is 3. And what will be left inside the bracket? 1 minus 4b square. Now you know 3 is one of the factor also. And 1 you know is the square of 1 only. So we have to write it into the form a square. Minus 4b square is the square of 2b whole. Now again it is changed into the form a square minus b square. So you will take it as 3. Keep on taking 3 because that is also one factor. And a plus b will be 1 plus 2b. And a minus b will be 1 minus 2b. So this is how 8th question has been done. There are 3 factors for this algebraic expression. Now I am taking up 11th question, which I removed it from here because of less space. Okay, I am going to take this 11th question at the end. First let us take up this 14th question. In 14th question it is x y to the power 5 minus y x to the power 5. Now again you see if anything is common term, there is some common term, take it out. So you see x is one power of x is common and one power of y is also common. So I am going to take xy factor common. What remains inside? Y to the power 4 minus out of x to the power 5, 1x has been taken outside. You will be having x to the power 4 inside. Now this is equal to xy is also one of the factor. Y to the power 4 is the square of y square. Which law I have taken? Law of exponent I have taken? Power law. To write y to the power 4 as y square whole square. Minus x square whole square. So now it will be xy. This is a, this is b. You will get it as y square minus x square as one factor because this is your a, this is your b, and y square plus x square as the other factor. Now we can factorize it further. The one which is having the binomial which is having minus sign in between, because in the formula also we have got a square minus b square. So this y square minus x square can be factorized further. It will be xy, and y square minus x square will be y plus x, y minus x, a plus b, a minus b, and this cannot be factorized further because it has got plus sign in between. So it will be written as it is. So this completes the factorization. Now I am taking up the 15th question. 15th question is a plus b whole square minus b minus a whole square. So this is equal to, this complete a plus b is the value of a in your formula, and this is the value of b. So I am going to write it as a, which is this, plus b, one factor. Other factor will be a plus b minus b minus a. First you should write it within the brackets, don't write it directly. So this clearly shows that it is a plus b, a minus b. Now we are going to open up the bracket. A plus b minus a, and the other factor also we will open, a plus b minus b, and this minus multiplied to minus becomes plus a. This is equal to a minus a factor is the term which is cancelled. You are left with b plus b, which is 2b, and here b minus b is cancelled, and you are left with a plus a, which is this, factors are multiplied, so it will be into a plus a 2a, and when you multiply them, 2 multiplied to 2 gives you 4ab. So this is the factor of 15th question. Now because of less of space, I removed this 11th question. Now I am going to do 11th question also for you. X to the power 4 minus y to the power 4. Now as I have done here, y to the power 4 minus x to the power 4. Same you have to do it here also. So x to the power 4 will be x square whole square minus y square whole square. Apply the formula of a square minus b square. Factors are a plus b, a minus b. So it will be x square plus y square, one factor. Other factor is x square minus y square. Again, I told you that this minus sign can be factorized further. It will be x square plus y square plus, if you have plus factor, you cannot use this formula. As I told you, it has got minus in it. So x square minus y square can be factorized further, and you will get it as x plus y and x minus y. Now this is how, if you write till here, your factorization is complete. But if you leave your answer in this step, your factorization will be incomplete and you are not going to get full marks. Because if you have to factorize, you have to factorize completely till the end, till where you can factorize. So I have done few questions for you from your exercise 14F of the chapter factorization. Again, based on the formula which we have used for 14E. Now come do this complete exercise in your copy. Do the other questions also. And in the next class or in the next period, I'll be taking up your problems.